just a bit outside. He tried the corner and missed.
All right, we are back. It is Sports Talk on a Monday night. Time now to go just a bit outside with Coach Jim Toman. He's been traveling a lot, watching his son play minor league baseball down in Florida, but also keeping an eye on everything happening in the college baseball world. Welcome. Where would you like to start? Paul Minari, Clemson in Florida. What's your pleasure?
Well, I think the biggest thing is Paul Minari right now. It's a bombshell. I mean, if they can pull that one off, Coach Tanner's really slipped one by everyone because didn't hear a whole lot about it. But it doesn't actually surprise me, Phil, because when Paul was recruiting my son Tucker, you know, Tucker signed with Coach Minari at LSU. And when he said to me, I want to coach for a long time, and I'll coach Tucker throughout his whole career. He said, I'm in great shape. I throw BP every day. This is 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I'll still be coaching. He said, we got it going pretty good here, and I'm healthy, and I'm throwing BP. He said, and the guy's in good shape. I think he's 66, maybe 67. But like I told someone earlier today, hell, Coach Donald Trump is 77, so if Trump can do it, I'll guarantee you Coach Minari can do it for a little bit longer than people think. That'd be awesome.
What do you remember about him as a coach? Did you ever, I'm just trying to think of his years, did y'all cross paths head-to-head?
You know, I never got – I mean, my first career win at Liberty was against Notre Dame, but I think he was already at LSU by then. So I actually won my first game at college as a head coach at Liberty. We went down to Florida and beat Notre Dame. I don't know if he was coaching or was someone else coaching. But anyway, I just know every time I've seen him, he'll say, hey, Jimmy, how you doing? How's Ray doing? Very, very – sociable, not afraid to talk to anyone, just a nice guy. And, you know, his dad was a longtime JUCO coach down in Miami-Dade, Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And so he has the coaching pedigree. He was brought up with it. And the guy has over 1,500 wins. So you're talking about a Hall of Famer. And if he comes here, the fans need to get ready to go back to Omaha. I need to get your tickets, Phil.
Mm.
And, I know you're going to buy me some steaks at the Drover, and we're going to have a blast.
I didn't think you went to Omaha without a team. I thought you had that old philosophy, not going to Omaha if my team's not going.
By then, I'm going to have the South Carolina baseball podcast with Jim Toman and Phil Kornblut as my guest recruiter by then. You know, if I'm not coaching, I may have a month or two career in radio podcast.
All right, let me ask you this before we shift gears.
Okay.
Let me ask you this because you know Ray Tanner as well as anybody. You know how how he thinks. First of all, kudos to Tanner because nobody had this name until Teddy Cahill busted it.
Well, I know why no one had it. I know no one had it.
Well,
I mean, I'm like his little brother, right?
Yep.
I worked with the guy for 11 years in South Carolina and 7 more at NC State, and he coached me for 4. And he did not even call me in the last 3 weeks. I haven't heard from the guy. I don't know if he's like in a bunker with Joe Biden or where the hell he is, but he is locked down. I'll guarantee you he hasn't even talked to Karen, his wife.
Mm. So,
because this was kept quiet. He wouldn't call me, text me back. normally, you know, he'll text me back in a day or two, or he'll call me. But the guy is just incognito, and I don't blame him. But the next time he calls me, I ain't answering, and I ain't picking up. I ain't talking to that guy for a month.
Well, be careful. Now, he might be calling you to say, hey, come work with this guy. But hang on a second. Now, let me throw this at you. So what do you think? I was speculating that Skip Bertman may have had a role in this, because Tanner Bertman, very close, you know, go way back, LSU connections there. Do you think
LSU is center with Coach Team USA with Coach Bertman, too. Yeah. And, heck, I don't know if Coach Benary might have been with Coach Tanner one year in that. I don't know. But they knew each other.
So my question is, all the names, you know, that were kicked around, the popular names, you know, Coach Lee and the coaches at all the different other schools, in your opinion, do you think Benary was the guy from the start that Tanner – he didn't just stumble upon this, I don't think. You think this was the guy from the start that he was going for?
Well, it's either one or two, Phil. It's either they had it, you know, they talked about it, or what probably is more of apt to happen is when Coach Kingston got let go, you know, Paul Menary might have called Ray and said, look, I've been trying to get back in for a couple of years. And he had some health problems, but, you know, they were – minor, and he told me he's in great shape, you know, just 3 years ago and through BP. I had a feeling that he wasn't done coaching when he was leaving LSU. So I don't know what happened, but, you know, Tucker remained committed to Coach Johnson at LSU, but then, you know, Tucker signed with the Toronto Blue Jays, so he never got a chance to go to LSU, but I have no idea. I don't think it was a done deal because he's been talking to these other coaches. So I think it was something he either picked up the phone and called Paul to ask for names or ask if he was interested, or Paul called him, which, you know, maybe that happened too.
Sure.
Maybe it was, you know.
Yeah.
I haven't got the info because you know, my big brother didn't call me.
Well, Coach Toman, there may be a reason, because we actually have some breaking news. Ray Tanner not only just getting Paul Menary in the fold, evidently he's also hired his new softball coach, John Whittle, the Big Spur, reporting in the last 10 minutes that former USC player Ashley Chastain, who's the current head coach at Charlotte, will be the new head coach at USC, and there's a Board of Trustees meeting tomorrow, so they may be writing several checks tomorrow, not just baseball, but also softball. But
yeah,
I wanted to shift.
Yeah,
he is.
Go ahead.
He's been busy. Wanted to shift gears away from the coaching search to get your take on what may have been the craziest baseball game I think I've ever seen yesterday between Clemson and Florida. Both sides of the coin, as you watched that, what was your takeaway? And if you're Kevin O'Sullivan, how do you handle that kind of win? And if you're Eric Backage, how do you take a loss like that into the offseason?
Well, you know, Nick Schnabel, their assistant, was one of my assistants at Liberty, and I got a chance to talk to Nick today, and, you know, he's devastated. That's just a hard way to end your season in the 13 innings, and you had a chance to win it, and you're winning. So it was devastating to coaches, players, and everything. But the one good thing that Clemson can take out of it is their program moved forward. I mean, they had not been to a Super Regional in 11, 12, 13 years. And they got there, and they were getting ready to play a third game if they just can get an out, get three outs, and win that ball game. And you know, they've had a great year. So, you know, I told Nick, you're disappointed right now, but in the overall scheme of things, Coach Backage and Coach Leggett and Nick, my former assistant at Liberty, Nick Schnabel, who's their third base coach, infield coach. They had a great year. So you look at it like, yes, we do. No one wants to lose like that, obviously. That was a tough loss for them, but especially the way they came back and, you know, Cannarella, you know, hitting a three-run homer and then making the Willie Mays catch in the outfield. That was tremendous. That'll have to go down. It was a great catch, but the timing of it, if he misses it, the game's over. I mean, that was tremendous. That might go down as one of the best college catches ever, based on the circumstances. Mm-hmm. But so Clemson can look at it. You know, they're going to be miserable for a while. I've been there. But in a month or so, they're going to say, damn, we had a damn good team and a damn good year, and they're going to be proud that they're in the Super Regional. And then in the next step, they're going to go to Omaha. That's probably in their mindset now. And they'll have a little, you think they might have a chip on their shoulder, and now we got the Super Regional and we were hosting it, we need to go to Omaha. So maybe they could just use that as a chip on the shoulder next year and get after it. For Florida, I will tell you this. O'Sullivan and me were rivals a little bit. Anytime you're at Clemson and I'm at South Carolina, it's hard to be friends. So I'm not exactly saying me and Coach O'Sullivan were friends, but we respected each other because we recruited against each other. But that being said, he's brought that Florida team to Omaha a bunch of times and won national titles. I'm not so certain this ain't the best job he's done keeping a team together through a disastrous year for Florida. Mm. I mean, one game over 500. They were worried about getting into the SEC tournament. They had a win just to get to 13-17. Then they lose the first game in that tournament, single elimination at that point, and they don't know if they're in. Well, now everyone knows why they were in, because any SEC team is dangerous. No matter if they're 29-28 or 40-16, you're looking at a team that was one game over 500 and they're in the final eight now. So it might be the best job of coaching for him. I don't know. He's won national titles, but this year he had to overcome a lot, and he's overcome a lot in the last couple of years. So kudos to him. Congratulations. I mean, that's tremendous. Great job of coaching right there.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think you answered the question I posed to Phil earlier. Does this validate them getting into the NCAA tournament? So I'll turn it around and ask you, if you're Kevin O'Sullivan, do you ask the team at one point in time, where has this unit been? Why weren't you guys, and I realize they played an awfully good schedule, but is this the team he thought he had that he's seen the last 2 weeks in Stillwater and at Clemson and he hopes to take to Omaha?
Well, sometimes teams have up and down. Sometimes they have injuries. Sometimes they have reasons that they're losing. Sometimes it takes the younger guys a little bit longer to figure it out. And if you're going to play well, the best time to do it is at the end of the year. And, they barely snuck into the tournament, but now, they win a regional. They win a super regional. They're hot going into Omaha. I mean, I've seen crazy things happen in the 2019-2018 winning the national title, but there's going to be eight really good teams out there, so they'll have their hands full. But, teams are always different. And, he'll tell you that this is the team we expected to have the whole year, and it just didn't go that way. For one reason or another, the kids didn't play up to Florida's capabilities. Now, they did play their number one schedule in the country, but I'm sure he expected to have, 40 wins. Usually has 45 or 50 by now.
Tell you what, by the way, Georgia's jumped out to a 5-0 lead on your boys from state, so it might be a turn out the lights. The party's
over.
That's
not true at all.
What?
It's not true at all. It's 2-2 in the third.
I just saw 5-0.
I'm watching the game. you sure that one's from yesterday?
Oh. Was that from yesterday, that clip I was looking at? Are you sure?
I'm sitting here watching the game.
You got to get a D1 baseball score, and I'll give you an update. D1 baseball.
I could have sworn I just saw a clip where it said Trey Phillips just hit a home run.
He did.
I thought it said 5 to June the 9th. Oh, that was yesterday. Oops.
He hit a home run yesterday, I think, too.
Yeah.
But he did hit a home run tonight.
Yesterday, it was 5-0 in the top of the third yesterday. What is it today?
It is 2-2 in the third.
All right, so it's not turn out the lights. Dadgummit. Sorry about that. 2-2. I didn't mean to.
I got you back, Coach.
Good luck to the Wolfies. We got to go because I got to get into recruiting. But give me 1 minute. Can you do it in 1 minute? Give me 1 minute of the umpiring ejection fiasco with Clemson there. I know you love a good argument with an umpire. Maybe you like to see a good ejection from time to time. But that should never have happened because they never ejected Mathis to begin with. The Clemson coaches, if that's what they were arguing about, never had anything to argue about.
Yeah, he didn't. The center fielder didn't get thrown out of the game, so I'm not so sure what they're so mad at. They should have waited to find out if he was going to get tossed. And at that point, you know, do whatever you want to do. But wait until you find out if the guy's getting kicked out. They were just doing a review to see what it looked like. And I think the NCAA has to come in and do something about the rules. If you bat flip or spike it, or, you know, which ones do you get thrown out for, which ones don't you? Do you get a warning for that? Does each player get a warning for that? Does the team get a warning? It's a little bit of a gray area there. But obviously, Coach Leggett, great coach, Hall of Famer, it was a shame to see him get booted, and Coach Backett gets booted, and I guess they had another volunteer, a student assistant got booted, and before you know it, you know, they don't have many coaches left. So it could have affected the game. I mean, who knows? But they needed to probably wait a little bit. But I don't know exactly what happened. You know, knowing me, I would have been out there. I might have got tossed before they did. I don't know. But,
all right, well, listen.
It was a crazy day. It was crazy the whole day, back and forth.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of emotion. We got to figure out what we're going to let players do after home runs or bat flips and stuff like that. You don't want to take the fun away from the game, but at the same time, it can't be out of control. And it seems like in the regional, super regionals, or Omaha, you know, a couple of years ago, you had Tennessee's coach getting thrown out, and one of their players getting thrown out in a very important, I think it was a super regional game. And then last year, there was someone thrown out, and this year, three coaches, and the player didn't get thrown out, but it's a little bit – I think the rules committee got to get together and figure out exactly what they're going to allow and what they're not going to allow. So it can be, you know, right across the board. It would be black and white. You know, you're out or you're not out.
Yeah.
So you don't need a review. You know, if they thought he slammed it down too hard, the rule should be you're out or a warning. But something has to be done. There's too much craziness going on, and there's too many people – You know, we saw earlier in the year when guys skipping around the mound and guys, you know, they've tried to curtail it by not making the players can't go to the home plate anymore. So they kind of, you know, they huddle next to the dugout. That's how they got around it. But, you know, some of them bat flips are out of control. But, boy, sometimes it's fun, and you never want to take the fun away from the players. But at some point, you know, you gotta have a little class and, you know.
Yeah,
it's just something has to be done with the rules, I think. And
right.
The umpires need to, you know,
right.
be fair to everyone.
We need to – that was a long minute. I just want to tell you, we look forward to talking about the College World Series. Your reports on Monday next week will be brought to us by the Drover. So
there you go.
I mean, we got the finest in meats. Finest in meats
Let's
waiting for you in Omaha.
Tomahawk ribeye, 30 ounces, medium with baked potato, just butter.
Legendary.
Right,
legendary. I saw Corey Miller eat a 40.
Guys.
I saw Corey Miller knock off 45 ounces there one night.
Wow, that's crazy.
And never Holy broke God. A sweat. Never broke a sweat. Thank you. We'll talk to you next week.
See you, Coach.
Okay, guys. Bye-bye.
Okay. Coach Jim Toman. A tomahawk. You ever have a tomahawk steak?
Have not.
Oh.
I've heard they're delicious, but I have not.
Bring your appetite.